heart is so giving. I don't know what to do if you clap. Do I just keep it going? Everyone sit in stock silence. His heart is so giving, and with his own quiet strength, it's no wonder that this man and the incredible organization that is GLAAD would come together tonight. GLAAD and Bob have a lot in common. They're both gay. I was told by 5 different people to cut that, and I was like, hell no. GLAAD is an organization that pushes Hollywood and the media to share the diverse stories of all people in real and memorable ways. It has played a leading role in creating a world where... Am I too loud? A leading role in creating a world where acceptance is the norm, a world where everyone can live the life they love. Every day, GLAAD is moving perspectives forward, advocating for fairness and truth, and changing narratives in print, broadcast, and online news sources. GLAAD is the superhero behind this movement, bringing LGBT characters to the big and small screen, pushing journalists, producers, writers, and studios to ensure accurate representations of this community are experienced by audiences all over the world. Bob has been an outspoken advocate for gay marriage. As a co-founder of the Tribeca Film Festival, he admirably uses his work and his powerful voice to make a difference for you. As many of you may know, Bob was deeply touched by his father, a wildly talented abstract expressionist painter, the late Robert De Niro Sr., whose namesake Bob carries with him in his life and with his own artistry. Robert De Niro Sr. was a gay man who struggled with self-acceptance at a time when organizations like GLAAD were not around. After his death, Bob felt it was his responsibility to commemorate his father's legacy as an artist in an inspiring documentary. In the HBO documentary, Remembering the Artist, Robert De Niro Sr., Bob, sorry, I'm not reading what to tell Robert. Bob shares his father's story with the world, a story that opened the hearts and minds of people everywhere. Around the time this film premiered, Bob said something in an interview that really resonated with me. He voiced the hope that this documentary would allow his children to fully understand the urgency of the present. He said, "I want them to stop and take a moment and realize that you sometimes have to do things now instead of later, because later may be 20 years from now, and that's too late."